Unfortunately, I don't have a lot of time to dwell on my predictions video for 156, I think it is now. So it's going to be quite brief. Apologies for that. I am working now on trying to get time to actually do this properly again. Right, their main event is a title championship between Josie Aldo and Frankie Edgar. Few interesting things to point out here. First, in terms of records, Josie Aldo is better, 21-1. His one loss is by submission, and it was a very, very long time ago. You're talking 2006. Frankie Edgar, not as good in terms of record, 15-3, but he's never been finished. And I have to say that I don't think that the split decisions that he lost at championship level in the division above were anything but bum decisions. I don't think, however, that this is going to solve it. I think Frankie Edgar should have remained at that weight class, fought a few other people, and then gone back into contention. His move down, we don't know how the weight loss will affect him, and that's quite a big thing. But then so is the fact that Josie Aldo has been out for a year with injury, and we don't know how that's going to affect him either. So there's a big question mark over both of them. I think that the explosiveness of Josie Aldo will get the better of Frankie Edgar here. I don't think he'll finish him, but I do see this as being a fourth decision loss for Frankie Edgar, which is unfortunate, I think, but it's the explosiveness of Josie Aldo, if, of course, he still is explosive. So that will be my prediction for the championship event. Right, starting at the bottom of the card then, we've got Francisco Rivera fighting Edwin Figueroa. Edwin's got the better record, 9-1, 8-2 for Francisco, and I feel that this will be a stand-up war in which I expect Edwin to win. I'm going to go for a TKO victory in the second. Right, newcomer Dustin Kimura with a perfect record of 9 is fighting Chico Camus, 12-3. Chico Camus amazingly well-rounded in the way he wins, and Dustin, his area of speciality is submissions, and Chico has never been submitted. I think that it will be a decision, because at least on the last couple of fights, Chico's been decision. Dustin Kimura, he's new and not from Strikeforce, so they're still sort of pulling people in from other places as well. He does have an exciting background by the look of it, you know, submission, TKO, etc. So that's why it's not going to be a squash match, but I feel that it'll probably be a Chico Camus decision victory. Enter Strikeforce import. This is Isaac Villa-Flag. He's fighting Yves Edwards. Records might be foolish here. 42-18 for Yves, 13-3 for Isaac. You know, indicate squash match, but I don't think so, because his last fight was a win over Gessius Cavalcanti. So he's obviously reasonably up there in terms of fighting calibre. And of course, they're both very well rounded in what they win by. I don't know a lot about the Strikeforce imports, so, you know, I'm going to say I hope that the experience of Yves Edwards wins here, but that could be foolish. I'll go for a decision victory, just in case. Another Strikeforce import, Bobby Green, 19-5, is fighting Jacob Volkman, 15-3. Again, I just don't know. I don't know enough about him, to be totally honest. I'm going to go with Jacob Volkman here. I think I might go for a... Ooh, what should we say? I might go for a submission in the second. Jay Herron is fighting Tyron Woodley. Now, I do like Jay Herron. Record is 23-6, and Tyron Woodley is from Strikeforce, but his record is 10-1, and that loss is to Nathan Marquardt, in fact. I think that Tyron Woodley will actually win this one. I'm going to go for a TKO in the third. The next fight is actually quite a hard one to call, I think. This is Gleison Tibau with a record of 26-8, and he's fighting Evan Dunham, 13-3. Now, I think that Evan Dunham will win this one. I'm only really going on recent records for this, and the reason is that they are both able to face high calibers and do very well. But I feel Evan Dunham is more on his game at the moment than Gleeson, and therefore will win. I am going to go for a decision, though. I imagine this next fight is for a number one contendership, really. Having actually the fact that both guys here, Joseph Benavidez and Ian McCall, have both fought Demetrius Johnson and lost. In fact, Ian McCall fought him twice, and technically speaking, lost. It was a draw, but in terms of championship bouts, had it been a championship bout, it would have, you know, constituted a loss. 11-3 for Ian, 16-3 for Joseph. I favour Joseph on this, but this one could be extremely exciting. I might go sorry to be boring. Joseph Benavidez, decision. In the last couple of fights, Demian Maia has seemingly improved. I don't think to the state where he's gone back to where he was, you know, as good as he was. But he may have improved enough to actually beat John Fitch. If he doesn't manage to get a submission, we all know it will probably be a John Fitch decision. But there is always the possibility of a submission here. And I think, do you know, I think I might go out on a limb, if you pardon the pun, and say, I will go for Demian Maia submission. Again, could be foolish. If there is any squash match on this card, it's Alistair Overeem fighting Antonio Silva. And I'm going to go for a TKO finish in the first there for Alistair Overeem. who knows? Anything could happen, but that's probably most likely. And the last one, this is Little Nog fighting Rashad Evans. I'm actually going to go for a Rashad Evans decision here. Not that I think he's absolutely fantastic or anything, but Little Nog is not Big Nog for a start. And secondly, if you just look at his recent record, you know, he loses to big names unless they are past their prime. So, you know, assuming that Rashad Evans isn't quite past his prime, despite what happened with John Jones, I shall go for him via decision.